For years, Alvirne High School, here in Hudson, New Hampshire, did not have a football team, and most everybody in this town knew why. It was because the people who originally endowed the school hated football. For good reason. Their only son died on the football field. People who left money, by the way, to create Alvirne High School were the Hills, Dr. Alfred Hills and his wife Virginia Hills. They were people who had a summer home here in Hudson. The Hills had the home constructed and they named it for themselves. They created a portmanteau name, by the way, for the home. Name that incorporated Al for Alfred and Vern for Virginia, and it came out as Alvirne. Dr. Hills and his wife Virginia had two daughters, both of which died in infancy. Their mother Virginia died soon after. Dr. Hills had a memorial chapel constructed, which also contains crypts where the remains of the two infant children and their mother are entombed. Dr. Hills himself was later laid to rest there. Chapel is called after the summer home. It's the Alvirne Memorial Chapel. And after Dr. Hill's death in 1920, money was given to create the high school, as I say, also to be named Alvirne. Now, you may have noticed that I made no mention of a son being born. And that would be the son who died playing football. And the reason for this is the fact that the Hills never had a son. Turns out the story was not true. The will never had a codicil stating that football would never be played at Alvirne, but nobody seems to know how this story ever got started, but fact be known, most people in town thought it was true for years. I must say, a lot of people were against adding football to the school base simply because of the costs. Football is an expensive sport. And so the story of the son's death on the field was not discouraged. And yes, Alvirne finally did create a football team, the Broncos, in, you ready for this, 1995. Great story, don't you think?